I'm Josh, preferablelife.com. I love asking people in my interviews about their daily routine. I want to give you many, many daily routine examples to help you define yours and nail yours down and crush your daily routine, because getting you to your perfect day is all that matters. So hear about Ryan's daily routine, hear the message about what he does not have in his daily routine, because that is maybe more important than what's actually in your daily routine.
Well, do you have a daily routine? Kind of walk me through a typical Tuesday for Ryan Baker.
Man, I think routine would be one of those things that's the next stage in bettering myself. I had a routine before I had daughters, but for the most part, it does look pretty similar. So I am pretty well in a routine of pray before I get out of bed. I want to make sure that I'm starting off on the right foot. And I recently, painfully recently, started praying before I get out of bed, just about my mindset, about the day, about my wife, my daughters, just everything, just kind of, you know, thanking God, praising him for everything he's done. And I find that that's way better than complaining about, you know, everything, like that I have to get up, being frustrated that my daughter is screaming and angry at 5 a.m. And it just gets me started on the right foot with the right attitude. And that affects everything else from then on. I'll go and I'll drink some water, take some probiotics, some B vitamin complex, which seriously helps with my energy levels throughout the day. I will usually grab a cup of coffee, either make one at the house with some breakfast, or I will go to a coffee shop, grab a coffee, maybe a small pastry or something. And then I'll usually write out my to-do list. I like to just put pen to paper, and before I get too many inputs from electronics, I will sit there with the pen and the paper and write down what I need to accomplish that day. Fine. Without that, I tend to be a little too scattered. And if that changes throughout the day, great. But I've got it written down. I know that I need to do it, and it's going to get done. So once I've got that list, I can crack open the laptop, start checking emails. Usually end up adding a lot to the list from that, and just kind of dig into client work. Sometimes I'll rotate between starting with client work and starting with my own personal research into whatever happens to be something I want to learn about at the time. So right now it's anything and everything customer experience management. You know, sometimes I'm digging into to current events, rarely, because I want to keep a positive attitude. Yeah. And, you know, sometimes I learn about, you know, coffee processing, in the roasting process. So how that affects the flavor. It's just, I like to always be learning something different. And, I really have been enjoying that as part of my morning routine. And after that, I come home, it's, you know, dinner, depending on what time I come home, it could be lunch at the table with the family, or dinner, and we'll play some games, play in the room. They're young. I have a 2-year-old daughter and a 2-month-old daughter, so we're relatively limited in what we do, but we'll go play outside, we'll walk in the park, just spend time together, enjoy, wind down the evening.
Yeah, that's cool. But approximately what time do you wake up?
Oh, goodness. That mostly depends on my 2-year-old daughter right now. So it's usually around 7:30 or so.
Cool. And what time approximately does the inbox check start?
I try not to check it before 9:30, 10:30. It depends on how long it takes me to get out of the house. Sometimes I'll spend a little bit longer at home with my wife. Perks of being self-employed.
Yep.
I get paid for results, so there's no punch card.
That's cool.
Yeah. Well,
something with your, I would assume, since you're 10 months into this, that staying away from Facebook and away from the email inbox and away from those distractions for as long as possible, is that something that you have over the last 6 months or so kind of learned throughout doing this, or is that something that started on day number one?
If only I was that awesome. No, it's definitely more of a learned thing. It doesn't help me, and it doesn't help my client, and it doesn't help my client's clients to immediately jump into email. I have yet to come across something in an email that was so important that it had to start at 6:30 in the morning.
Yeah.
You know, if they want to call my client, you know, or my client wants to call me at 6:30 in the morning, go for it. My phone's on silent when I sleep.
Yeah.
I'm going to miss that call. Hope everything's okay.
Yeah.
But sleep is so important to your health, to your mindset, to everything. Turn your phones on silent. It's going to save your life. Not all day, just when you're sleeping.
Yeah. Before this entrepreneurial endeavor, did you follow more news and check more news and current events and world events than what you do now?
A lot. I did. Yeah. I was really into politics. I was really into current events, conspiracy theories, finding out like why the world was going to burn and die and preparing for it.
Yeah.
I had 6 months storable food set aside. I still have a couple seed banks, you know, that might be more fun to garden with, but, you know, it's, I was letting it rule my life, and I was angry, and I wasn't moving forward with anything that I wanted to do in life. And when I stopped paying attention to all that, the world kept going and I moved forward.
And that is so huge. That's like the most powerful thing in the world. So it's tough to know that on the other side of it though. Like, yeah. Like how can you have ears to hear that before you can?
Yeah. Especially if it's the first time you're hearing about all these things, it's like, I have hidden knowledge no one else has ever heard. I'm the wisest person alive.
And yeah.
It's wrong, man. It's fear.
Yeah. Fear. That's a good thought. That's cool, man. Well, baller. How old are you?
I'm 29. I'll be 30 in October.
Yeah, that freaking rocks. A mover and a shaker, Ryan Baker. Age 36, Lookout World.
Lookout World for age 36, Ryan Baker. That's absolutely right. It's really, really hard to convey this message. I wish that I had ears to hear it before I started my entrepreneur journey. I believe this is the trick in getting off of your news feeds, off of your Facebook, out of your email inboxes until a certain time in your day. All they want to do is make money from you. They want to keep you on their news site to show you more ads. They want to keep you on Facebook to show you more ads. If you hear this and you do this, even before you're an entrepreneur, before you're trying to go to your perfect day, this one thing can change everything for your life. Stay informed, sure, but man, get these things out of your head. They are stealing your life away. And if you can hear it and implement it, things will start to change for you. If this helped you out, hit the like button. Share this with someone that needs to hear the message that was inside of it. And have an awesome day with no news, no Facebook, no email for as long as possible in your day.